All right. Good morning, or good day. Here, we'll make a simple home or office security alarm using the following components. We have the microcontroller board. We have the sonic distance sensor, and we have the speaker, and we have the LED over there, and we have the PCB that will allow us to connect everything. The 5 volts and ground connections are already embedded in the PCB. And let's take a look at the connections. The speaker is currently connected to pin number 3 in our setup. The LED is currently connected to pin number 15, also known as A1. Pin 15, or also known as pin A1. For the distance sensor, we have the following connections. We have the VCC, that's for 5 volts, ground, already embedded here in the PCB. Then you have the connections for trigger and connection for echo, the echo pin. So for the trigger, connect the trigger pin, pin number 2, digital pin number 2. For the echo, connect it to digital pin number 4. That would be our connection. Same connection with your robot, it's the same thing. Same connection with the robot. If you have your robot, there is no need to disassemble. But to show everything, I have the minimum setup. Okay? You need the PCB, you need the microcontroller board, the distance sensor, and the speaker, and the LED is already found on the PCB. Right. So let's work on the code. So what we want to do is, we basically want the this device to set off, no, as an alarm if the distance is greater than 200 centimeters, which is basically 2 meters, and this device will basically point at the door. So when the door opens, the distance should be greater than 2 meters or 200 centimeters. So let's work on the code. So we have this IDE, the Arduino Integrated Development Environment. If you click File, you click New, you should see the following. You should see the function for the setup. So everything that you put here in setup will only happen once. And you have this loop function. Everything that you put there will be repeated over and over again. So let's declare some things. I'm going to declare a variable. The name of the variable is LED. It will be equal to number 15. I'll put a comment to help me understand or remind myself later that 15 is also known as pin number A1. Right. So I'm doing this so that I don't have to remember anything. So I'll just make a variable and save the value there. So if I need to make changes later, I'll just change the number here. So the variable will be of type byte, which would mean that the variable LED will consume 1 byte of memory, a space capable of storing numbers from 0 to 255. And I'm going to specify that the variable, aside from being consuming 8 spaces or 8 bits of memory or 1 byte of memory, it will also be constant, which would mean that I don't have to, or I have no plans of changing the value later on. And I'm going to do the same thing for the speaker, and it's currently connected to number 3. It's also a byte, and I will also do the same thing for the trigger pin for the distance sensor. So it's I'll name it as trig pin with capital P. It's connected to pin number 2. If you don't want to type, just copy, make and paste and make changes, so you don't have to type that much. It's currently connected to 4, and that's it. And then before the program starts, I need to do some setting up, since the code that will be placed inside setup is part of this block of code or this function setup. I will need to indent. So basically, I just press tab to indent and I start typing the code. So here, what I want to happen is I want to set the pin mode of the four pins. Let's start with the LED. I'll set the pin mode for the LED to output, because the mode of the pin may be set for output or input. I'll do the same for speaker. Okay, so LED refers to number 15, speaker refers to number 3. If there are changes later, I'll just make changes here in the declaration area. Okay, so again, this is where you declare things, and this is where you want things to happen before everything or anything starts. I'll do the same for the trig pin. And for the echo pin. But it will be set as input. Okay. And then, so you have those. And then, before I proceed, I need to come up with a function, because the code for in using the distance sensor will be a bit lengthy. So I'm going to put all of those lines of code in a separate function. I will name the function distance. Open close parentheses, braces or bracket. So this is the start of the function, and this is the end of the function. And then I'm going to set the function as float, because the function will return or report a value which is a floating number, which basically means it's a number with decimal places. Alright, so here I'm going to again indent my code, and I'll start by making a or declaring a variable. I will name the variable duration, and the type is long. It's basically similar to float. It's basically long basically allows me to store larger value with no decimal place. And then I'll set duration to 0. And then according to the manufacturer, I need to trigger the distance sensor for it to work. So take note that these are not eyes. Basically, this is the transmitter and this is the receiver. So I need to send trigger the sensor to send the sound out, to be transmitted out, and we'll basically have to check how much time it takes for the sound to return using the receiver. So I'll basically have to send a signal. So I'll use digital write, send a signal to the trigger or the trig pin. I'll send a high signal, or that's 5 volts. It's the same as putting one there, but I'll use, although it's the same thing. And I need to the signal needs to stay there for 10 microseconds. Wait for 10 microseconds before, oops. Before removing the signal. Okay. And it is also recommended that we send a low signal first at the very beginning. For at least 2 microseconds, just to make sure that it's totally empty before we trigger it. Okay, so this will trigger lines 25-27 will trigger the distance sensor, and we are going to use the function pulse in. This will basically wait until the echo pin gets a signal, and it will count the number of microseconds that it will take before it encounters the high signal, and whatever value is reported by pulse in will save it in duration. Okay, and we're going to return or generate a value based on what is saved in duration. So that will be duration. Let's divide it by 2. Let's divide everything by 2. Because we only need to compute for the distance from this sensor to whatever is in front of it. So let's divide by 2. And then divide by 29.15, because apparently sound travels at 29.15 microseconds per centimeter in normal atmosphere. There. Okay, so we have the function now. Let's double check later if everything's okay. Let's go back to the loop function and let's start the code there. Okay, so again, this is the start. This is the end of the function. And what I want to do is to check if the distance. Okay, so this function will generate a value. If the generated value is greater than 200, in this case, that's 2 meters, because there are 100 centimeters in 1 meter. What I want to do is I want to turn on the speaker and the LED. So let's start with the LED, digital, right? LED, so that's high. I'll do the same to the speaker. Otherwise, I'll switch it off. Else, I'll switch it off. I'll just copy and paste in there. So this will be low. This is low. Okay, and I think that's it. Let's double check the connection. I'll click tools. The board is currently Arduino Nano because that's our board. The processor is either this one, 80Mega328P, or the old bootloader, whichever works. And the port is not yet there. So currently in my setup, I have two ports, COM12 and COM13. Let's connect this first. Let's find out. Click tools. Port is 4, okay, so port COM4 is currently selected, and then let's compile and upload at the same time. Click. So currently uploading. Okay, so it's currently working and it's basically pointing at nothing, so which would mean that the distance is more than 200 centimeters, so there's something in front of it, and the LED and the speaker is currently off. If I remove the obstruction, it will get a value which is greater than 200, and let's look at the LED. LED. Let's try it on the robot. So they have the same connection. I'll just plug this in. Okay, it works the same way. But let's upload the program. Let's try again. Okay, however, in this case, the old program is trying to upload. Okay, let's make it quiet. It's trying to upload, but it's not uploading. It's because it has the setup will be different. Let's click tools. So for this robot or for this setup, we have to select this one. So in your case, it depends on your setup. It may be this one, 18 mega T28P or old bootloader. In this case, for this setup, it has to be the other one. Upload and let's check. Okay, done uploading. There, and it should work. And for now, back on your robot. And for questions, just check the video again or consult with me. Thank you.